For this week's look at the crop markets, we're taking a lighthearted approach with a nod to two classic entertainers, Roy Clark and Archie Campbell.
Dr. Anderson, good to see you again.
Good to see you, Dave.
You look a little shaggy on top.
Yeah, I need my ears lowered about an inch.
Well, today's your lucky day. I am here at your service. And speaking of lowering, I understand that the latest WASD report came out from the USDA, and stocks were a little lower in that, too.
Yeah, they lowered U.S. wheat stocks from 608 million bushels down to 558, and they lowered world stocks down to 6.8 billion bushels. You know, that made U.S. stocks well below average and world stocks slightly below average, and that resulted in higher prices.
Well, that's good.
No, that's bad.
Well, how come?
Well, those WASD numbers are already factored into the market. It's going to take additional information to get prices to go higher. That March contract, you know, it's got support at 660 and resistance at 693. The July contract's got support at 630, resistance at 650. We got to have that information.
Well, that's bad.
No, that's good.
Well, how come?
Well, you know, the USDA also lowered the corn ending stocks numbers to below 1.5 billion bushels. Remember, this last, 2 months ago, we were talking about having 2 billion bushels of ending stocks on corn?
Mm-hmm.
And that resulted in higher corn prices.
Well, that's good.
Well, no, that's bad.
Well, how come?
Well, corn prices are still below wheat prices, even though they've went up. You look at the demand for wheat and what this last harvest, the feed demand for it, said, well, those high corn prices probably added 85 cents to the price of wheat. And that's just not going to be there this next harvest.
Well, that's bad.
No, that's good.
Well, how come?
Well, because we produce the best hard red winter wheat or the best bread flour in the world, and there's going to be sufficient export demand for our wheat domestically and for our wheat on the export market. And you know, this next week on February the 21st, USDA is going to release the first supply and demand estimates for that 2014 wheat crop, and you know, that's going to support what we've been talking about.
Well, that's good.
You bet your sweet bippy it's good.
Okay. Well, now I can get to work.